Hey there, what is up? Today we're going to learn how to make a slider. We're going to make a height slider that will go from 100 to 220 centimeters. If you are American, then feel free to change it to feet. I don't really care. So this is what we're going to end up with, a slider that works very well. So if you're ready for it, let's just cue the intro. So the first thing I want you to notice is that I'm using a setState widget, and that's because I'm going to need to use this variable right here, and it can't be final. This, as the name reveals, is going to be a variable that will contain the slider's value. The reason it's 150, it's because that's going to be the default value. That's the value that the slider will always start with. So let's just get to it. I'm going to add a slider widget right here. And the first thing I'm going to give the slider widget is a minimum, which takes a double, and it's going to be 100. And then a max, I'm just going to do 220. There are NBA players who are taller than that, but that's very rare. And then we need the onChanged property. This is pretty much what's going to control the slider's value changing. It takes an anonymous function, but you need to give it an argument of type double. Let's just call it value, and this works without this, but I'm gonna leave it in for educational purposes. However, this is still highlighted because there's still a parameter that's very important that I haven't used yet, which is the value parameter. This is essentially the value that will be displayed in the slider. This is exactly where we will use the variable I showed above, the slider value, because this will always represent what the current selected slider value is. Whatever the user ends up leaving your slider with is going to be the slider value. And let's just print the value here just so that you can see how it works. And I'm talking about this value right here. In fact, let me just call it val just to make sure there's no confusion. I'm going to save the app and I'm going to show you this right here. So you see it's printing. It's going to be weird because this won't change, but just watch what happens. Just move it. And as you can see, the value is updating, but not on the UI. So let's take care of that, shall we? First, let's use this variable right here and make it always equal the val each time the val is changed. But if we save it like this, nothing will happen. Why? Because we need to use setState. That's what's going to make the UI update whenever you change the slider. And let me make this a little bit sexier with some better colors. You got active color. I'm going to give it colors dot deep orange, and then inactive, I'm gonna give it colors.black, just so you can really tell the difference between the both of them. And now I'm gonna hit save, and the colors are looking better, and if I change the slider, it does move around. And the value is being updated, but you can't see anything because we haven't taken care of that UI-wise. Please hit that lonely like button if you're learning something, I would really appreciate it. And one of the possibilities to make the value show up on the UI as you change it is, for example, you have a text widget, which in this case is 100, which is this 100 right here. And we can just use the variable. In this case, I'm going to do round and then toString, but there's other ways to do this. This one works, so why not do it? I'm going to hit the save button, and you already see that it has updated to 135. If I change it around, it just updates very beautifully. This is pretty much already a working slider right here, but we can do even more with it. We can come over here and use the property called divisions, and for example, between 100 and 220 is 120, so if we split 120 by 6, for example, we will get divisions by 20, like so. I don't know if you can see this, but there's little dots on the slider. You can't see it here as well, but they're also present, except they're white, and here they're black. But now when you slide, it goes through the divisions. Like right now it's 100, it goes straight to 120, 140, 160, 180, 200, 220. This can come in handy, and obviously if you use a number like 106, it doesn't work. It needs to be something that is logical and makes sense. For example, if I do 10, it moves every 12 centimeters. And we can get even more specific, like 32. Basically, all you gotta do is take the difference between min and max, like so, and then split it by the number you used, and it will tell you the span that you'll get. This is moving forward every 3.75, which is why here it's 4 in the beginning, and then, for example, here it goes up 3, etc. And finally, you have the label property. And here, what makes more sense is to take this right here, dot, let's just do it to string, I don't need to round it, just to show you what it would look like without the rounding. If I hit save, watch above the circle what happens. Now we have a visual representation of the exact value we're at. Now, obviously, this would be terrible UI because you'd have two different values being shown, but imagine this doesn't exist right here, and then this is very helpful. However, one important detail, if you remove the divisions and you hit save, it doesn't show up anymore. You need the divisions in order to show the label. But anyway, I'm just going to leave this right here on my true height, and I'm just going to say that if you'd like to know how to style the slider, where you can even change the size of this circle and do much more interesting stuff, like you can even change this color right here that shows up when you slide it around. I'm talking about the outer circle surrounding the smaller color circle, you can really change pretty much anything you want about how the slider looks. And once I upload that video, I'll leave it on the top right now. That's it for today. If this was helpful, hit that like button and subscribe for more Flutter tutorials. That will be it for today. Thank you for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.